jealous of my life. So I decided, not decided, I discovered that a lot of my personality traits are also pregnancy symptoms. Probably pregnant too. So I go to get an at the health center, right? And the weird thing is that you can buy everything in the pharmacy section. You can like pick it out, purchase it, go on your merry way, except your pregnancy test you have to pay for in the lobby, which is part of like this shaming of female sexualization. I don't know, it's horrible. So then the lady was like, would you like a bag? And I was like, no, I'll just carry it, thanks. Supermarket. And I go back to my house, and you pee on the stick, for all of you that haven't taken a pregnancy test, and then you have to wait 5 minutes for it to, like, ferment, I don't know. So I was like, what can I do to take my mind off of this? Want to know what exactly takes 5 minutes? Reheating a frozen breakfast burrito. So then, imagine my joy when I find out, not only am I not a mom, I also have a toasty breakfast burrito. Speaking of words that are Spanish in origin, does anyone watch Narcos? Okay, it's a great show. For those of you who don't watch it, it's on Netflix. It's about Pablo Escobar, and he's a Colombian drug lord. So it's a fantastic show. Oddly, since I was a child, I've always had this thing where I like root for the bad guy. Like I was like, Regina George is the prettiest, and she should be with Aaron Sanders. Yeah, Cruella, those dogs would make a beautiful coat. And so I'm watching this show about Pablo Escobar, and like the DEA agents are breaking into his house, and I'm like, no, run, take the cocaine with you. But the other great thing about the show is that it's teaching me Spanish, because a lot of it is in Spanish with subtitles. So I can already say, Narcos. Traficantes de los drogas. Pablo. Don Pablo, which is like Pablo but more respectful. And so, yeah, as you can already probably tell, I'm a hit with the men. And here's some evidence of that. So, my bedroom has recently become somewhat of a vortex for the lost belongings of men, nay, boys, whom I have loved and lost. So it started like this. A guy sleeps over. No, it doesn't sleep over. He leaves at 3 a.m. But a guy comes over. And a couple days later, I find his boxers, like, tangled up in the bottom of my sheets. First, I texted a few people to be sure they were his boxers. And then the next time I saw him, I was like trying to be flirty. I was like, hey, like you left your boxers in my apartment. He was like, you can throw them out. So I text him and I was like, hey, like, you left your watch here. And he was like, you can throw it out.